The National Library of Medicine is proud to present Desalination, a solution for our water needs. Did you know 97% of Earth's water is salt water from oceans?
That's a lot of water. If there's so much ocean water, why don't we just drink the water? I don't get what everyone's saying about all these water shortages and stuff.
It's not that simple. We can't drink salt water.
Why not? What would happen if we did drink it?
Well, the salt in our food and drinks ends up in our blood, but we can't have too much salt in our blood. Our kidneys use water to flush out the extra salt, generating urine that exits the body. This is one of the reasons we need to drink water.
But if urine leaves the body, then getting rid of salt must cause us to lose water from our bodies.
That's correct. And what is seawater?
I guess it's just water with a lot of salt dissolved in it.
Exactly. So say you drink one cup of seawater, and say in that cup there is a tablespoon of salt. The amount of salt in that cup of water is so high that it would take way more than the one cup of liquid you drank to remove the one tablespoon of salt from your body.
So drinking seawater causes you to lose even more water than you drink.
That's right. And losing too much water causes dehydration, which is very bad for you.
It's such a shame. There's so much salt water. If we could only get rid of the salt, we wouldn't have to worry about water shortages or anything like that.
Well, there is actually a way to remove salt from seawater. It's called desalination, and it's more familiar than you'd think. During the water cycle, water gets desalinated. After a rainfall, the water flows toward the ocean. Energy from the sun causes the salty water to evaporate, leaving the minerals on the ground. The pure water travels upward as a gas until it hits cold air and condenses, forming clouds. Then fresh water falls as rain.
Hold on, condenses? What's that?
What is condensing? It's when water gas cools and turns into a liquid. Have you ever drawn pictures on the bathroom mirror after you take a shower? The water on the mirror came from your shower. When the water is hot, part of it turns into gas, which then rises in the air. When the gas comes into contact with a cold mirror, it cools or condenses and turns into water. Again, clouds are just condensed water in the air, and those clouds produce rain. Although nature produces fresh water, it is a precious but limited resource. Desalinating ocean water provides much-needed fresh water for people to drink, especially those in locations without much.
So how do they do it?
Well, there are two types of desalination. The first is called thermal desalination. Thermal desalination is similar to the water cycle. Salt water is heated so that it evaporates, leaving the salt behind. The evaporated steam is then cooled and condensed into pure water.
Like on the bathroom mirror!
Thermal desalination is a good method because it works and can handle large volumes. However, it does use up a lot of energy. Another method of desalination is membrane desalination, which uses semi-permeable membranes. A semi-permeable membrane is a thin sheet of material with tiny holes that let some amount of liquids, such as water, but not solids, like salt, pass through it. To desalinate, membranes are used in a process called reverse osmosis. This process involves tanks divided by a membrane. Pressure is applied to the saltwater side, forcing water through the membrane from the side where there is more salt to where there is no salt. Since the membrane only lets liquids in, the salt gets left behind. Reverse osmosis is more efficient than thermal desalination, meaning it produces more fresh water for less money. However, a reason not to use reverse osmosis is that salt and other particles get stuck in the membrane holes, causing them to stop working. Membranes also get old and break down. Because of their short lifespan, membranes must be replaced frequently, which is expensive.
That makes sense. So if we have these technologies, why are there still water shortages?
Industrial desalination is not yet our main source of drinking water because it requires a lot of energy, making it expensive and harmful to the environment. Furthermore, harmful leftover salt is hard to dispose of safely. However, scientists have started combining technologies to make desalination more efficient, such as using both membrane and thermal desalination technologies together, and finding better ways to power desalination plants.
So while we have a long way to go, desalination really is a solution for our water needs.